In this video, I'm gonna share with you 4 ways to automate your user onboarding process without making it sound too robotic or impersonal. Hey friends, it's Ramli John from AppQs. If you want to get the best user onboarding tips and tricks, be sure to smash that subscribe button. Now, onboarding comes in all shapes and sizes. So what works for one product might not work for yours. But there are some standard onboarding practices that nearly all products could automate for a more efficient and engaging experience. If you want to automate your onboarding, here are 4 best places to start. Number 1 is to create an automated email campaign. Now, communication is key in any relationship, and the relationship between a product and a new user is no different. Welcome emails are an essential part of this customer communication strategy because they increase early engagement by up to 33%. When users are engaged, they're far less likely to churn, which means more dollars heading your way. Now, welcome emails are also dead simple to automate. Instead of manually emailing each of your new users with slightly different versions of the same email, you can use a product like MailChimp to do it for you. And now that you've got the automation train started, you don't want to stop it with one email either. Use automated emailing throughout your onboarding to introduce product features or re-engage users after the first week. An example of this is with CloudApp. Now, CloudApp uses automatic emails to help users who get stuck with the onboarding. But that also frees up its team to handle direct upsell communications like this one, which users who are more likely to buy might get. Number 2, organize new users into cohorts. Personalization is key to building a great onboarding experience, but doing it manually is likely to lead to personalized headaches, if you know what I mean. Avoid the hassle and let automation tools do the sorting for you so you focus your effort on delivering new users a good experience. One of the easiest ways to sort new users is to have them choose their own onboarding adventure with a survey. Who's better at sorting your users than, well, your users themselves? At the beginning of their onboarding flow, Headspace meditation app asks users what they want out of their meditation practice. Users are then placed into unique cohorts with onboarding materials that help them achieve those selected goals. You can use this same trick with your own product by customizing the questions to funnel users into relevant cohorts. But the real fun begins once new users are sorted, because that's when you can begin personalizing the onboarding experience. Number 3 is design onboarding flows targeted at user activation. The best onboarding flows build toward an activation event, an aha moment where users get to experience the real value of your product. If you're Amazon, the event might be one-click shopping. If you're a debt consolidator, it could be a customized financial plan to get your clients out of debt that they accrued from one-click shopping. The trick is that different user cohorts could have different activation events. Since you've already segmented your users based on the previous suggestion, you'll need to understand that each cohort's activation event is so that you can optimize it for that. You can find your activation event by studying your user data, surveying and interviewing existing users, and brainstorming with your team. I've actually created a whole video about finding your aha moment in 3 steps. You can find the link below. After that, you can start building onboarding flows by working backwards from the activation event for each of the cohorts. Ideally, you want these flows to be as short as possible so users see the value of your product before they have time to leave and say goodbye to your product. Number 4, develop self-service resources to support users. Your onboarding flow might be done, but that doesn't mean your users are done learning. You want to continue to encourage users to interact with your product, adopt new features, and get more value over weeks, months, and even years to come. One way to encourage these behaviors is to create self-service resources where users can learn about your features at their own pace. Creating these resource documents can help, number 1, answer common customer questions, reducing the strain of your customer service team. Number 2, teach users how to complete more technical or advanced tasks with your product that weren't addressed in the onboarding. Number 3, promote continued engagement in your user base for higher retention rates. Now, an example of this is Zendesk that does this brilliantly. they've created an interactive knowledge base using their own app with several helpful articles and tips. Once these resources are created, don't forget to promote them. Make users aware of these help docs by introducing them in your onboarding and drawing the attention to them with in-app messaging. To wrap it up, the benefits of automation are enormous. User onboards on their own schedule, you're freed up to do more important job, and the people that you work with don't have to send the same welcome email hundreds of times a week. It's a win-win-win. Well, that's all for now. I hope this video has taught you how to automate your user onboarding. I just wanna know which product has a great automated user onboarding experience. I'd love to know them in the comments below. Just type it up, I'll reply back. Also, if you found this video valuable, feel free to share it with your colleagues and your friends. We've also created a free user onboarding certification course that details how to create an onboarding experience that turns more of your users into paying customers. We've got the link below. Make sure to click on it and check it out. Also, don't forget to subscribe to get the best tips and tricks to improve your product's user onboarding. There's a link right there. Check out our other videos as well. That's it for now. This is Ramli John from AppQs. See you in the next video.